Hi, everybody. My name's Meaghan Anderson, and I'm an extension field agronomist with Iowa State University. And today I'm here with Ryan Bergman, a program specialist in our Ag and Biosystems Engineering Department. And Ryan is going to have a discussion about fertilizer spreading when we're using an applicator like this with a spinner spreader on the back. Ryan, this is a topic that's important this time of year. Can you tell us a little bit about some considerations that we might make when we are applying fertilizer with a spinner spreader?
Yes, in general, we need to think about calibrating our machines regularly. We want to calibrate for every product that we're going to apply. We should calibrate for different blends that we might apply with the machine. And then also we should calibrate as products might change throughout the year. And then also we need to calibrate at the different rates that we're going to apply. It can be difficult to calibrate at every rate that we might apply. So we generally recommend, pick the rate that you use most often, or kind of the general range of rate that you use, and apply in that or calibrate in that range. And then as you move the rate up or down, hopefully at least you have you're well calibrated for kind of the middle ground of the rates that you typically use.
Ryan, I see you've got some tools here on the table in front of us.
Yep, thanks, Meaghan. These tools are important. We'd like to see these in the cab of, most fertilizer spreaders, the people are using, so they can regularly check on their material properties and make sure that, we don't see any major changes throughout the season. So this first one is an SGN, is a sizing tool that we use. This tells us the range of sizes that are in a particular fertilizer that we might be applying. You load it here, you shake this back and forth, and then this will show you the distribution range of the fertilizer that's in your blend. The second tool here is a crush test, and this tells us the hardness of every particle. So we use this and we crush a variety of particles, and that'll tell us how hard each particle is. Both of these are used in conjunction with each other to determine how to best set up the machine. The size and the crush test play into helping us determine how fast we can spin the spreaders on the back, which ultimately plays into how wide the machine can spread out in the field with a given product at a given rate.
So what happens, just out of curiosity, if we have some particles that are not very dense?
So if we have a harder particle versus, a lighter particle, a less dense particle, less, something that's not as hard, what can happen is, as we spin those spreaders, we might spin them too fast, and we can actually crush or pulverize that particle and turn it into a powder. And that powder is not going to spread near as well as the original hard fertilizer particles would themselves, and will likely end up with a concentrated band right behind the machine that can be problematic from an agronomic perspective. So using the information that we get from using these tools, we can then come to the setup guide manual for the machine. And by using the combination of knowing the particle size distribution along with the crush test numbers, we can then set up our spinner speed and determine the proper swath width for our machine for that fertilizer that we're using. Also, when we're applying blends, we can use the combination of the information for each product and determine how to best set up the machine for that blend, assuming that we have similar products. When we talk about particle density in dry fertilizers, we often like to use the analogy of a golf ball and a ping pong ball. They have very similar sizes, but very different weights or densities to them. I can throw a golf ball a lot further than I can throw a ping pong ball because it has more mass to it. This applies to dry fertilizer much the same way. A heavier particle, we are going to be able to spread further than a lighter particle. We'll be less impacted by wind and other forces. This is also important if we start to blend fertilizers, that we make sure that we understand each of the fertilizers that we're blending, understand their particle densities and how that affects our ability to spread them evenly and not get segregation of the products as we spread them.
You've given some excellent tips with regard to calibrating our machines, making sure that if we're mixing products together, that we're doing so in a way that is going to allow us to use those in the best possible way. Do you have any tips for our applicators with regard to maybe environmental considerations or anything else we need to be thinking about for applying dry fertilizer?
I mean, in general, we know, the calmer the day, the better. So today, pretty windy out, especially, even early on in the morning, not a great day to spread. But we certainly do understand that, sometimes work's got to get done regardless. So some things we can pay attention to if we're spreading on a windy day is the direction that we're driving in the field. Ideally, we want to drive parallel with the wind, so into or out of the wind. We'd like to avoid situations where the wind's blowing at the side of the machine and we could see a side shift in the pattern. That can become more problematic. Also, we want to think about our guidance systems and how wide we're trying to spread. We may need to narrow the machine up and not spread quite as wide on a windy day to make sure that we maintain good quality across that area. Also, just general kind of multi-year management, so not driving the same exact guidance line every year, varying the direction you drive, can also help avoid sort of long-term issues with, you know, building up higher rates of product in certain areas if we do have misapplications year to year. Today we mostly discussed and talked about setting up and calibrating a machine based on the fertilizer quality properties. But it's also important to make sure that we're regularly pan testing our machine for the different products we're applying, which is also a key part of making sure we have proper spread and distribution of all of our fertilizer products.
Ryan, I really appreciate you showing us some tools that we can use to make sure that our fertilizer spreaders are properly calibrated and giving us a few tips to help make sure that when we are making these applications, that we're making them in the best way to be efficient and to make sure that our applications are doing what we need them to do. So thank you for joining me today.
Thanks for having me, Meaghan. And we hope everybody has a safe season and we get good results by properly setting up the machines.